Thanks to the hard work of our contributors, and thanks to the friends of GNOME, we're proud to announce GNOME 3.14. With this release, GNOME brings an improved desktop for its users and developers. The visual details in GNOME have been revised, and new animations have been implemented to improve your user experience. This release also brings better support for multi-touch. You can now use swipe and zoom in a multitude of GNOME apps. GNOME Shell also has new gestures. For example, when switching workspaces and opening the activities overview. With help from GNOME's community and from this year's internship participants, a lot of the GNOME apps have received updates. Software now supports app add-ons. Maps gain navigation routing. Photos can import your photos from Google. And Weather's interface was redesigned. Furthermore, Clocks and Calculator have new search providers, so you can check the time and calculate live in the search field. Sudoku and Mines were redesigned for a better gameplay experience, and a new game, named Hitori, is now a part of GNOME Games. With GNOME 3.14, developers can look forward to a better development environment. GTK has begun an ongoing effort to improve the developer experience. This release ships with GTK Inspector, an interactive debugger made to improve your debugging workflow. GTK also comes with more documentation, including a brand new set of human interface guidelines. Apart from the news for GTK, this release brings more stability to the GNOME compositor in Wayland. Furthermore, glib has gained new features, like Unicode 7 compliance, and support with the new MIME apps spec. Many distributions will ship GNOME 3.14 in the future. If you can't wait, try out our demo image in the description, or come join us in making our next GNOME release even better. We look forward to getting you started.